So I'm about to go to the provost skenes house, and to show you that I've been putting this off for a while, how close it is to me, we can look and see that it is actually just right outside the window of my hotel room. I'm looking at it every morning. It's the first thing I see when I get up. So this is the provost's house here, and I'm gonna go in there in a little bit because the place is freaking awesome. You don't even believe it. Doesn't look like much. It looks like an old house from like 1400 something, but the place is amazing inside, and I'm getting all giddy just thinking about it. There's all kinds of science stuff in there, and I love it so much. I think it opens at 10 or 11, 10, 11, Saturday. And so yeah, like again, it doesn't look like much, but the place is awesome. And yeah, it's like basically a mini Disneyland in there. It is really cool. I love it so much. And I can't wait to get in there when they open. It is great. More James Clerk Maxwell stuff. So this reads, James Clerk Maxwell's theory of Saturn's rings. When he was in Aberdeen, Maxwell began to study the arrangement of the planet Saturn's rings. Scientists could not understand why the rings did not crash into or move away from the planet. In 1859, James published his detailed essay on the stability and motion of Saturn's rings, in which he argued that Saturn's rings consist of concentric rings of satellites made of small solid particles. To prove this theory was mechanically possible, he created a model using two parallel wheels attached to a crank handle. Attached to one of the wheels were satellites that turned in circular motion as the axle rotated, demonstrating the wave patterns the satellites were ring. There's a description of his model here. You can see it. Prior to James's theory, scientists believed Saturn's rings were either fluid or solid circles. His theory on Saturn was confirmed 100 years later when the Voyager space probe took photographs of Saturn. Look up to see a model. So here we go. Up above here, we're going to push the button and you're going to see something happened here. Let's just see the, I guess there's not really much going on. But that's pretty cool still. Fun to hear. When it comes to world first, the people of Aberdeen have punched above their weight for decades, and today invention continues to thrive. With more patent applications per person than any other city in the UK, including London, Aberdeen remains a hot spot for inventors. Self-belief and determination are evident in the extraordinary achievements featured here, from the inquiring minds of inventors Alexander Forsyth and Robert Thomson to the work of astronomer David Gill. These pioneers achieved excellent pursuit of their goals. It's really nice. It's really empowering. It was here in Aberdeen where James Clerk Maxwell, one of the world's greatest scientists, was able to make up a professorship aged only 25. So we have James Clerk Maxwell's example of his color wheel. So you can see that he was the first person to understand that all colors can be made from red, green, and blue, and to understand color blindness. Here's a color wheel. He would take a top and spin it. He can make any color by using the distance from the center, and even white and black, and spinning it. He actually took the first color photograph as well. He took one of a tartan. I think this is an image of it, and he used three color filters to gels to expose the different colors, and he was able to make the first color photograph. That's an example of it there. His actual color wheel is here, you can see. Obviously the top part isn't original, but the rest is Maxwell's actual color wheel. Incredible, so incredible. And look at how the little adjustments he made to make it exactly level. I actually got to see a bunch of tour buses stopping at this guy's house, Thomas Blake Glover from Aberdeen. He was a true innovator, moved to Japan and helped start the Mitsubishi Corporation and brought modern shipbuilding to Japan. It reads, In 1908, Emperor Meiji recognizes Thomas's outstanding contribution to the industrialization of Japan by bestowing upon him the honor of the Order of the Rising Sun. Of Thomas's many legacies, one of the most enduring was his role in the development of the shipbuilding company, which became the Mitsubishi Corporation of Japan. He also introduced the first steam railway locomotive, the Iron Duke, to the country and played a crucial role in founding what would become the Kirin Brewery Company. Pretty cool. Then we had 3D photography by George Washington Wilson. Here, he had this first stereoscope photography. It looked like 3D images. I would show you in here if I could, but can't, but it looks amazing. And this fireplace, this has got some, above the fireplace, has some wolf's heads on some swords. I'm not sure, gratis a deo data. I'm not sure what that means, but this is the fireplace here. Kind of a checkerboard inside to it. And there's a little door over here. And the ceiling looks like this. Okay, so we're gonna go up. Painted gallery. Come in and see the painted gallery. Well, don't mind if I do. Wow, it smells super old in here. And well, it's 500 years old at least. But here, look at the painted gallery, the ceiling and the walls are painted. Where's I can it's some looks like sort of medieval scenery here. It's an angel and it looks like a woman reading a book. And it looks like perhaps Christ, I don't know. But it's a good bet. It's a interesting room. Wow, I can't even explain the smell of the place. It's so old. I don't know it. And the wood itself is, you know, just kind of creaky and old, of course. Very interesting. How do I get out of here? Let's see. Just going to keep going up. You can see out the window here how high up we are. The stairs are really worn out in the middle from centuries of foot traffic. Oh, we don't want us going any higher, which would be super cool. We also have William IV Seiss as the first one to use a percussion cap, a non-powder loading priming gun, which we all use today, the percussion ignition of firearms. Pretty cool. So you use the primer and a percussion cap. And we have Robert Thompson, who made the first pneumatic tire. He also, I believe, he invented the first self-filling fountain pen and the first steam tractor, and the first time someone could detonate an explosive charge by electricity instead of using a burning fuse, which saved a lot of lives. The first heliometer for measuring distance between astronomical objects is here. And the same person who was a student